Hmm.
How'd you like a part two?
Of 60 versus 60. I don't even remember if I did this.
Oh well. Guess a rematch is a good idea. I have a fuck ton of darks. And I mean, a fuck ton. I think it's a better get going. In the IZ, it's going to be lightweight stuff, and in the W916, it's going to be heavy stuff. So in the IZ, it's going to be stuff like t-shirts and boxer shorts, along with pairs of socks. And in the W916, it's going to be heavier stuff, such as hoodies, pairs of jeans, and even
a whole onesie.
Because why not? Yes, a lot of stuff. There's like two weeks worth of my darks, I've no idea. I don't even have the foggiest clue. I think I do know, I've got a hell of a lot of boxer shorts. Also t-shirts, because you know. I don't even know if all this is going to go in one. I've no idea. Socks. More random shit. Jesus. That's finally it for the 916. Oh my god. Wow. That is ridiculous. I don't even know if all this is going to go on. I doubt it. Oh well, Milo abuse. Yet again. Because why the fuck not? I've abused this thing so many times. Oh dear god. I think it might all fit. Who knows? Yeah, it's all going in. Just. Okay, I said just. Nope. Okay, I guess instead of doing light and heavy shit, I'll switch it instead. So, a total of 10.5 kilos. Storm with Super Ins. I don't know why it just preloaded. Cotton's 90. I don't know. Did that? What was that me? I don't know. My mind is blank. Okay. Taking short wash off because I know what the tendencies are for this W916. So, what I'm actually going to do is take the laundry out and I'm going to press all the laundry down the counters. I'm actually going to pop the aerial in on top of the clothes in the IZ. If I put it in the dispenser, it will chuck the aerial all over the door glass and it looks hideous. So, I'm going to grab quite a decent amount of aerial. I'm going to put it in at the back on the tub and then push the rest of the clothes in and then the onesie. So then the jet system can soak all of this without detergent until the drum rotates.
which is good, actually. I'm going to add pre-wash on with the W916 on the side for some pre-fill. And as you know, I've been using Ariel this entire series, and I'm not going to stop. Unless I run out of the stuff, which I doubt I ever will. So, that's Ariel in. And I will add... what's going on, Ace, again? Alright, instead for this one, I'm going to give it a bit of a twist. Fan of the scent of these as such, but they're decent enough for my taste. And back the IZ as you do. Middle of the W916. Never place them at the front or in the bottom of the tub, as when everything starts to tumble, it all comes. So, without further ado, I suppose I will begin episode 6 of Two Washes, One Room. So, I guess enjoy. Wash on the W916. I've got genuinely no idea which machine will win at this point now. Now, obviously, the timings look super messed up, and it's obvious that the IZ's going to win at this point. But you're wrong. The W916 has fuzzy logic, the same as the IZ does, but the IZ doesn't really change its time. W916 can easily. So let's see what the hell happens. Because I'm also curious. So we will see which machine wins. Which loses. Alan 6 is kicked on to washing now. No hesitation at all. Because when the hell did Amila hesitate? Especially not a W900 series. The jet system is on in the IZ, and it's going to fail all the way this time, and then put the jet, and then well, it's going to fail all the way this time, and then it's going to tumble. Unlike on quick, where I think it... unlike on the regular, which I think it doesn't tumble at all. It just goes for it. That's a really cool sound. The W916 is obviously going to sense this as a full load. It's most likely going to reduce to about an hour and a half. And then it's the battle of which will win. Filling again in the W916. The slight woes of not having a jet system. That could be far worse. Could be like a shitty candy, and well, we all know what happens there. Top of after top of after top. The same with quite a few modern machines, actually. Beckos are quite notorious for not topping up as many times as you might think, as they actually do use a hell of a lot of water, my WTB included, which is actually now Jack's NK4900. all struggling today. Oh no. Yazad's definitely gonna get this one in the back. Whoever's, well, whichever machine's just turned the heater on, I can hear it going wee. That sounds really cool. Surprisingly, this is working out quite well. Hopefully.
Thank you.
Oh god. This is the second time it's done this. I just had to pause it. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Shit. That's good. Yeah. Okay.
Wait.
Okay. That's the first time the Milo's ever come close to smacking the cabinet with new shocks. Now that is a beast.
Okay. I actually thought that was... I don't know if it actually has. I wasn't really listening. But I swear to God I saw the floor move. I swear I just saw that floor flex on that corner. Jesus. That's 103 kilos just trying to move again. With perfectly brand new shocks.
I might need a new set of 140 newtons for this fucking thing. Jesus. Perfectly balanced. Got about 600. Oh, it's decided not to.
Weird.
there goes the extension lead.
And it's warp speed time.
God damn.
Beatles always do it the best.
They always.
I mean, you never know when the hell they're gonna go bad. And you don't know what a sod song's about to happen half the time.
It's meant to. Well, it's meant to be better, isn't it?
And the eyes edge training as well.
Nice.
It's going to be about a 7 minute interval between. Or about 10, you know.
Well, let's see from the eyes edge.
But still, somehow, the W916 has yet again won a wash race. I don't know how many it's done so far, but I think it's won for every episode. The next episode is going to be with Bedlam, which is episode 7. But then for episode 8, I'm actually putting the W916 in the garage to go against the W754S, which I will call, again, two washers in one room. Because it's technically still two washers going against each other in one room. But the other reason why it's going in the garage is because the floors in this utility are raised and also wooden. So if I put the if I put the 916 here where the IZ is, I put the 754S there, it doesn't matter which way around I put them, the floor is going to fucking collapse. Because the W754S, even if you, most likely, if I took out the front weight band, it would weigh as much as this Zanussi IZ. To put that into perspective, the IZ weighs about 80 kilograms, and a W754S weighs 112. Well, it, most likely, actually no, I think the IZ weighs about 80, and the W754S weighs 112. So, for a little bit of perspective on that, both of the front weights, well, there's two cast iron front weights that are put together with a couple of little bits of metal, and basically you're able to take them apart and pull them off the outer tub. That's 30 kilograms. 31 if you include all the attachments and the bolts and stuff. 31 kilograms down, the machine still weighs as much as the average washer. That's without half of the weight in there. Because the other half, the other half of the weight is the bearing cross,
in the back of the top, and the extra is 15 kilos for the Murat 27 motor, which weighs 15 kilos by itself, which is like 5 more than the average motor, and is also a hell of a lot bigger. But if you're wondering about it, a W754S is fully commercial built. And when I say commercial built, I mean it literally has Coinbox on the parts list. So does this W916, but seeing as how it's a W900 series model, it technically doesn't qualify being commercial, but it sort of does in a way, as it's, yeah, they're both based off the WS series. Well, in fact, the WS series was based off these. The original WS series, which includes the WS5405 and 5406 models, was based off the Miele W700 series. And then the later WS series, which included the WS5425, 5426, 5427, 5428, 5438, 5545, I think, or 5546, I can't really remember. And probably quite a lot of other models was based off the W900 series. And in the later ones, they had inverter motors which had spin brakes on them, which is incredible. For the early 2000s and commercial technology, it was brilliant. Now, these models ranged from being literally regular models, slightly more beefed up with extra suspension, with slightly upgraded suspension and other things like that, which is basically just a regular 13-amp plug with a drain pump, exactly the same as this W916, or they can range up to 3-phase power, which is 5,200 watts with a dump valve, a coin box, and a pedestal, literally everything you can think of. Updated parameters, things such as extra, things such as spin speed control it's exactly the same as a W916 would, but all the way up to 1250 RPM instead of 1600. Shit like that, which is incredible. But for the commercial series, they were very popular for what they are. The WS5405 and 5406 models are quite rare, whereas the 5425s and 5426s in particular are the most common. They're literally just like finding a bottle of Coke in the Coke factory. It's ridiculous. Like, you can find them everywhere. I mean, it's just incredible. Like, I've never seen any commercial models of Miele's be as easy to find as the later US models. But in, I think it was like 2006, maybe, I don't know, 2005, 2006, they moved on to the PW models, which are beefed up based on basically just nearly any modern Miele. Basically, it can literally be like a W562 that's just been taken and beefed up. That's how easy it is. But essentially, the controls are very similar to a Navitronic. Spin speed is 1400 RPM on all models, I think. They range from 5.5 kilograms to 6.5 kilograms. And they can have quite a lot of things. They can have off the top of my head, there's 13 amps, which is regular with a drain pump or a drain valve. There is 32 amps at 240 volts, which is drain pump and drain valve. 400 to 480 with a drain pump or a drain valve, and specialised 400 to 480, which includes no neutral, which is all wired these days, for marine applications, which is drain pump or drain valve. And there's also quite a few other machines, such as specialised models, that I can't really think of off the top of my head. But there's
a hell of a lot of variation with these. And yeah. They do not mess around.
And that is episode 6 of Two Washers, One Room. Thank you for watching. I'm Washington Central. And I guess I'll go and see you in the next episode. So if you're wondering about the next episode, it's going to feature these two again for the last time. I'm going to be washing bed linen in both machines to figure out how the hell I'm going to take it. Obviously, perfectly fine. And the next episode 8 is going to feature the garage for the first time with upgraded lighting that you guys have not seen before, other than on my community posts and also Instagram. If you're wondering, the absolute legend who did this is Laundryard 1400. Check him out. I will leave his channel link in the description. I will also tag him because, you know, why not? So, yeah. This has been a hell of a series so far. Thank you guys for the support. And, well, I'll see you in episode 8. And, well, hopefully this goes well. I've had a lot of fun today. I had a lot of fun yesterday as well, because Jack was around. Jack was around yesterday, and that's when we did the lighting and a bit of plumbing. So I'll get to that later on
tonight, if I have enough time. No, I don't think I've got enough time now. Meh.
I don't care if I have enough time, I'm just gonna still do it, I don't mind. Depends if it's raining. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in episode 7. I'll just have to think then, Jesus. Because it's been episode 5 just gone, which I washed a giant load of towels, and this is episode 6 with a, well, double darks wash. So I'll see you in episode 7, which features bed linen, and then episode 8, which features Germany 1. The Germany 2, 1986 versus 1996. So, I will see you in the next episode, whenever that is, and wherever it is. Bye-bye for now.